Hey, what's Sparkles?
Hey, buddy.
Hey.
Yeah, you look more homeless every day.
Well, I've just been working.
I just wanted to see if you're looking good for tomorrow.
You put plug wires back on. We were just adjusting the valve train on it.
I think you might be a little bit further ahead than us. Ours does not have a drivetrain yet.
Ours runs and drives.
Look at you, dude. I'm so proud of you. Growing up, getting ahead of schedule on stuff now. You look like you're really hot, bro.
Dude, it's like 120 degrees.
You're going to lose weight just sitting there in your shop.
I still got this.
Yeah, but it looks
that's
good on you, dude.
So bad. It's like a heating blanket on me.
This is going to be interesting, man. Maybe after I kick your ass in this race, maybe I'll bring this down and do a victory lap around your town.
You ain't kicking my ass, man.
All right, buddy. Well, good luck. Hey, we'll see you tomorrow. You're going to lose. He's so cocky. Chet is so, I love, that's what I love about him and I hate about him. He is so damn cocky, but he's ahead of us right now. So I think he has the right to be a little bit cocky. This is gonna be interesting. I honestly, like, Chet from 2 years ago couldn't have pulled this off. He's grown a lot. Like, he's come a long ways. This will be interesting to see what happens. Like, I'm legitimately feeling like we've got a competition ahead of us. I gotta get to work.
It's the day of the tough truck race.
Dang! Dude, this thing's awesome.
And we're still trying to finish our truck.
We got the transfer case reassembled, put back together, now going back in the Jeep.
There it is.
But we still have so much to do before this Jeep is ready to go take on the tough truck course, and more importantly, the Ruth brothers.
Well, we just rolled in here at the Harriman Tough Truck Challenge where we're gonna race Sparks and his crew.
Sparks Motors? They're not here.
I don't even think they've even got the truck started yet.
Probably not. We're gonna win by default because they're scared.
Well, here we are, 7:45. Sparks still ain't here.
But we've had our truck done for almost 24 hours already. And he's still working on it or still bringing it out here. I don't know.
They're here.
The Diesel brothers are in the house. And they have laid down a challenge to the Goose Garage.
We made it. Literally, like, this is the tightest time frame we've ever, like, I'm working on the Jeep as we speak. We've got approximately 10 feet of driving on it so far, and it's a packed house. There's literally only standing room out there. It may have been one of the fastest builds we've ever put together, but it also may be one of the coolest. We shaved some weight by getting rid of the entire roof of the Jeep and the windshield. We were also able to bring the engine back to life with a new fuel pump and battery. To protect us on the track, we've got a full tube roll cage to give this unibody Jeep a proper platform to be able to go out on that track and absorb all the bumps and jumps. We built a completely fresh I-beam frame. It allows us to mount those big military-grade independent suspension systems front and rear. We rebuilt the transfer case to make sure that this Jeep can make it around the track for all 5 laps. And we finished it off with a beautiful American-themed Billy Luber spray paint job, along with rear steer from the Brodozer. If Chet and Tyson beat us, you guys are gonna have to blur our faces. Like next season of Diesel Brothers?
Chet, Tyson.
The Blurry Boys.
All right, well, this is where shit gets real.
It's like Rocky versus the Russian. He's got the equipment, we don't have the equipment. We're running through the snow, carrying logs, hacking the whole world, and he's in there on a machine with
machines telling him how his heart's working. Yeah.
What happens? What? He goes down every time.
America. Basically, our strategy is just beat him out on the whole shot because the track's so narrow that he won't be able to pass us again.
Why does he look so nervous?
All right, dude. Chet, kick their ass, dude. Let's do this. smoking him. Word ahead, Sparks didn't stand a chance. He can't win unless he's cheating.
Happened he had that little spatula he had on the front. It got me. Flip us upside
There's
down.
A reason he put it on there. Let's face it.
Hey, let me see it.
I had you on.
Let me see it, man.
Yeah, you did.
Come on, the truck has a spatula. What do you expect? I mean, it was designed to flip things over.
Dude, you caught 15 feet of air.
That's what I was going for.
Bro, you brought a spatula.
Feel pretty bad for my crew because we all put in a lot of time. You know, we wanted to finish this race. But to come out, to perform, to have Sparks and those guys still, you know, be pumped and happy for us.
It's gonna show people what we're capable of doing.
We can do it.
And that's the biggest thing.
Come here.
Catch me, dirty.
I was gonna beat you.
Well, here's where we're at, guys. We will post and build your business. The fact that you made it here in the short amount of time with that budget, that's like mad respect, like good job. Yeah.